here, what we are doing? We are using some logic to solve these problems. But now, if we take a Cobb-Douglas function, and what we have, Cobb-Douglas production technology is given as k to the power l a and l to the power b. How can we solve this? Now, what we have is minimize cost, that is again r k plus w l, and what we have to do is minimize with respect to k and l, fine. And what we have here is such that, and write here k to the power a l to the power b is equal to q, fine. How can we solve it?
So, here we have to use the tangential relation.
Two, three different ways we can solve it. One, notice that the Cobb-Douglas, in the case of Cobb-Douglas, the isoquant looks like this, okay. And of course, we have to find an isocost such that it is parallel to this isoquant. And how can we find the find it that the isocost line is tangent to this isoquant? How can we give the tangent to this isoquant? What is the equation of a tangent to this isoquant?
MRTS,
basically MRTS is the slope of this isoquant. So, first what we can do, this is pure mathematical way, again we will come back and we will try to solve it little bit differently. What is the MRTS? MRTS is
dk by a.
This is MRTS, okay. And what is FL? Basically, marginal product of labor divided by marginal product of capital. These are the same thing, okay. So, what is the marginal product of labor in this case? B k to the power a b minus 1. And what is marginal product of capital? A. And what we get?
K
by a. K by, this should be same as the slope of isocost line. And what is the slope of isocost line?
Minus
w by l, or minus w by r, sorry, thank you. So, what we get basically is that one condition is that minus b a multiplied by k by l should be equal to minus w by r, fine. And what we get basically is, if you look at here, b k r should be equal to a l w, and this is an equation in two unknowns, okay. What are the unknowns? B is given in the equation, A is also given in the equation. This is R and W are market determined. What does this firm need to decide? K and L. So, these two are the variable for this problem, fine. Second equation, how do we get the second equation?
We would calculate Q naught, the amount of output.
Second equation is from here, Q is given, Q naught is given. And what we have is k a l w. So, what we can do from here, I am not going to solve it completely, just giving you a hint. What we can do? We can figure out l in terms of k and q naught, okay. So, what we get? Q naught by k a to the power 1 by b. Fine. So, now if we put it back, b k r a l is nothing but q naught to the power 1 by b k k to the power a by b w. In this, we have only one unknown, that is k, and we can solve it. What did we use? We use the tangency criteria. So, somewhat we have used mathematical and little bit of graphical understanding of the problem. Another pure mathematical way is just to look at the problem again, minimum r k plus w l. We have to minimize with respect to k and l, and what we have here is k to the power a, such that k to the power a and l to the power b is equal to q naught. We can get rid of one of these two variables right here. Fine. What we can get? Let us say, let us get rid of k in this case. So, k is q naught by l to the power b whole to the power 1 by a. Fine. So, what we are saying basically here, that k and l are not independent of each other, they vary in one particular way, and this equation gives that variation. So, what we are saying basically, we are making it as a function, that k is an implicit function of l basically, and we plug it back. So, now instead of minimizing with respect to k and l, what we have is we minimize only with respect to l, and r k we can give from here. And this is one equation where we have to, which we have to minimize with respect to l, and we minimize it and we get the, what we can get? We can get l as a function of l as a function of r w and q naught, okay, or let us write here just q. And k is also a function of r w and q. Is it clear? So, what does this give? Let us focus on this equation only now. What does this give?
Minimum amount of labor required to produce.
Not minimum amount of labor, the amount of labor required to minimize the cost of production of Q, minimize the production of output, when the market price of labor is W and market price of capital is R, not the minimum, this is the amount of labor you require. So, in other word, what is L? L is the amount of labor that this firm demands from the market. So, can I say this is kind of a factor demand? Fine. And we also put a word here, conditional factor demand, not just factor demand, a conditional factor demand. What is it conditioned on? That it has, you know, L is not just a function of R and W, it is also a function of Q, the amount of output required. That is why we are putting a word there, conditional. This is conditional factor demand. If you want to correlate it with a concept that we have learned during consumer theory, this is very much like Hicksian demand. What did we do in the Hicksian demand? We kept the indifference curve fixed, we kept the utility level fixed, and we said what would happen to our demand of a particular consumption good when the market price of this good or the other goods change. So, that is what we are talking about. Here what we have done? We have kept the isoquant fixed. We have kept the isoquant fixed, we are not changing the isoquant. And what we are talking about? So, what is happening basically? Let us see graphically, let us see what is happening here is, this is isoquant. Let us say depending on a particular value of R and W, our iso cost line is this. If value, let us say what happens if the slope is minus W by R, if W goes up, what will happen to the slope? If W goes up, it will become steeper. It will become steeper. So, how would it look? Probably, of course, not exactly. It will look like this, and we are moving here. That is why, remember, it does not matter whether W has changed, W has increased, or R has decreased. We will move from the factor demand, would move from here to here, and see what is happening basically. If W has gone up, labor is becoming, labor has become costlier. So, what would this firm do?
We would start firing labor. Would reduce the amount of labor.
Capital instead of labor. Huh. It will produce the, in the production, it will use more of the cheaper input. Yes. And which one is the cheaper in comparison to other? Capital. So, the amount of capital would increase to produce the same amount of output. Fine, is it clear? Okay. So, that is what happening here.